morning class. I'm Mr. David Ayoro, a teacher of chemistry. Welcome to our class. The topic is still electrochemistry. In our previous lesson, we discussed about voltaic cells as sources of energy. Today, we want to discuss the preferential discharge of ions at the electrodes during electrolysis. So, under electrolysis, what is electrolysis? Electrolysis is the process of breaking up of an electrolyte by passing an electric current through it. Passing electric current through electrolyte, and the process, in the process, the compound breaks up. That process is what we call electrolysis. So you have to be well familiar with these terminologies: electrolyte, anode, cathode, cations, and anion. These terminologies we discussed in electrolysis 1. So in electrolysis 2, you must know the electrolyte: anode, cathode, cation, and anion. An electrolyte is a liquid or a molten substance which allows electric current to pass through it, and eventually it is decomposed. Anode is the positive terminal of the electrode. Cathode is the negative terminal of the electrode. Cations, these are the positively charged ions, and anions are the negatively charged ions. So, preferential discharge of ions at the electrode during electrolysis. We have got factors which affect the selective discharge of ions at the electrodes. The first factor is the position of the ion in the electrochemical series. The second one is the concentration of the electrolyte. And this second factor only affects the ions, the halide ions, that is the fluoride ions, chloride ions, bromide ions, and iron ions. It does not affect the hydroxide ions, the sulfate, or the nitrate. Then the third factor is the nature of the electrode used. And this one affects only ions at the anode, if you use the electrode which is not enough, that is the graphite or platinum. So let us look at the first factor, the position of the ions in the electrochemical series. So this is the position of the ion in the electrochemical series. You find that we have got sulfate at the top, nitrate, fluoride, chloride, bromide, iodide, and hydroxide. So that if you have got all these ions, hydroxide ions is the most little discharge compared to other ions, followed by iodine, followed by bromide, followed by chloride, followed by fluoride. But nitrates and sulfate will never be discharged at any given time. They cannot be discharged at any given time. That is sulfate and nitrate. So these ions will move to the anode, electrode. So the second one are cations. You know the from one, you know how to arrange elements in the reactivity series. So the first ion which will be least discharged is the potassium ion, followed by sodium ion, then calcium, then magnesium, aluminium, iron. After iron, we go to lead, zinc, then zinc, lead. Then between lead and copper, we have got hydrogen. Then lead, hydrogen ion, copper, mercury, silver, and gold. So gold is the most readily discharged compared to all the ions, while potassium ion is the least readily discharged. So these ions will move to the cathode electrode. Let us look at the examples. Now, number one, let us look at the electrolysis of dilute sodium chloride. So if you consider the electrolysis of this solution, it is dilute. It means that the chloride ions will not be so much. It will not, the nature of the nature of the concentration of the ion will not influence the ion. So we only look at the first factor, the position of the ion in the electrochemical series. So you can be given a diagram like this one. Then you are told to identify gas X and gas Y, then identify the electrodes Q and P, then explain why the volume of gas X is twice the volume of gas Y. So if you are given a question like this one, we are talking about the electrolysis of dilute sodium chloride. So ions present from sodium chloride, we have got sodium ion and chloride ion. From water, because it's dilute, water has been added. We have got hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. So at the anode, which is the positive electrode, the negative ions will move there, the chlorides and hydroxide. So if you check the chloride and hydroxide, you find that hydroxide has got a higher tendency to ionize compared to chloride because it is lower in the electrical series. So it is hydroxide will discharge, and it will discharge to form water, oxygen, and some electrons. So if you are asked to state the observation at the anode, then you talk of bubbles of colorless gas, which relights a glowing spleen produced at the anode because it's oxygen gas. And we find that it's one volume of oxygen gas produced plus four electrons. So at the cathode, the sodium and hydroxide will move there. But if you compare the two ions, you find that hydroxide ion will be discharged in preference to sodium ion. So the hydroxide ion will receive the four electrons produced at the anode to produce two volumes of hydrogen gas. So at the hydrogen at the cathode, you find that you'll observe bubbles of colorless gas which burns with a pop sound, that is hydrogen gas. So in our question, we find that gas X is now hydrogen gas and gas Y is oxygen gas, and electron Q, where one volume of gas produced is the anode, because the anode is where one volume of oxygen gas produced, and electron P is now the cathode. And if you are asked to explain the reason why volume of gas X is twice the volume of gas Y, you can write the two equations. In this one, you write the anode, at the anode, this equation. At the cathode, this equation. Then you write one volume and two volumes. Or you can explain that the four electrons produced at the anode are accepted by the hydrogen to produce two volumes of, accepted as the cathode to produce two volumes of hydrogen gas. So as the process continues, the concentration of sodium chloride increases as water molecules are removed from the solution. You know, we are removing water molecules, we are removing hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion, which are elements of water. So we are going to find that the concentration of sodium chloride will increase, and as the concentration of chloride ion will increase, it means that chloride ion will now be discharged at the anode eventually instead of hydroxide. So what we'll observe is that bubbles of green yellow gas produced at the anode by the end of the electrolysis. So because the chlorine gas will be produced since the concentration of sodium chloride shall have increased. So the second factor, concentration of the ions in the electrochemical series. You find that let's look at electrolysis of sodium chloride, which we call brine. So the ions present here is sodium chloride, which is sodium. The ions present here is sodium ion and chloride ion from sodium chloride. And from water, we have got hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. So at the anode, the negative ions will move there, the chloride ions and the hydroxide ion. But we find that because the concentration of chloride ion is more than hydroxide, so the hydroxide ion has got a higher tendency to accept to release electrons compared to hydroxide. So it means that chloride ion will be discharged in preference to hydroxide ion because the concentration of the chloride ion are higher. You find that when it was dilute, it was hydroxide ion produced. But if it's concentrated, it's the chloride ion produced instead of hydroxide. So the ionic equation there is the chloride ion discharges to produce chlorine gas and some electrons. So under the observation at the anode, you'll find that bubbles of green-yellow gas produced since chlorine gas is produced. At the cathode, sodium ion will move and hydroxide ion. you find that between sodium ion and hydroxyl ion, sodium hydroxyl ion has got a higher tendency to accept electrons compared to sodium ion because of the position of the ions in the electrochemical series. So the hydrogen ion receives the two electrons to produce hydrogen gas. So observation here is that vapors of colorless gas produced at the cathode. Vapors of colorless gas because it is the hydrogen gas produced at the cathode. So this is the equation for the formation of hydrogen gas at the cathode. So if you are asked to write the two equations at the anode and at the cathode, it is the chloride ion producing chlorine gas and the hydrogen ion producing the hydrogen gas. So we are remaining with the third factor, that is the nature of the electrode used. And this one will only affect the ions produced at the anode, this one. And we are going to look at it in our next lesson. Thank you. Let us continue next time.